Howard, Seabiscuit missed the next big cap because of an injury, but was brought back in 1940 to challenge the 1939 winner, his own stablemate, Kayak II, and 11 other runners. Seabiscuit carried 130 pounds and Kayak 129 as a crowd of 68,000 watched.
Coming down the stretch the first time, it's Whitby in front between Specify and Seabiscuit. Seabiscuit on the outside is second by an X. Specify on the rail is third by a neck. Royal Crusader on the outside is fourth by a half a length. Wedding Call is fifth by 2.5 lengths. And Don Mike, Mike County is next, and Ra. Into the back stretch is Whitby in front by one length. Royal Crusader is second by a head. Seabiscuit is third by a head. Wedding Call is fourth on the extreme outside by 3 lengths. Specify is fifth by a length and 1/2, and Vi County is sixth. Around the far turn, it's Whitby going to a drive by 3/4 of a length. Seabiscuit is second by a head. Wedding Call is third, and Glenn Can't Wait. They're turning for home now with the Wedding Call in front by a head. Kayak is second by a head. Seabiscuit is third by 1 length. And by County into the stretch, it's Seabiscuit in front by a head. Kayak on the outside is second. It's Kayak and Seabiscuit head and head. It's Seabiscuit on the rail. Seabiscuit and Kayak. Seabiscuit and Kayak. They're coming down there, and Seabiscuit. Seabiscuit wins it. A new world champion comes down there. He wins it. And listen to the crowd. All by himself. Seabiscuit by 2. Kayak is second by 1.
Seabiscuit reached the pinnacle of his career that day, setting a track record of 2:01 1/5. He was retired after the race as the world's leading money winner with earnings of $437,730. Known as well in the West as across the country, the gallant bay horse even inspired Hollywood. The story of Seabiscuit starred Shirley Temple, Barry Fitzgerald, and Lon McAllister on the silver screen. Hollywood focused on Santa Anita from the track's earliest days, drawn by the glamour and excitement of the new track. Box seats were occupied by celebrities like Betty Grable, Don Ameche with Tyrone Power, Louis B. Mayer and a young Frank Sinatra weighing the merits of the horses in the next race. Al Jolson, Bing Crosby, a horse owner himself, Robert Taylor with Barbara Stanwyck, John Wayne accompanied Liz Whitney Tippett, prominent thoroughbred owner and breeder, who once had a screen test for Gone with the Wind. And on opening day of 1971, the familiar figure at Santa Anita was Ronald Reagan, then governor of California.